Hey guys, today we will draw a cute deer with a forest background and shade it using my textures and patterns set. If you don't have it yet, you can download it together with cute flower stamps and color palette in the video description for free. If you'd like to support this channel and access even more tutorials and brush sets, make sure to check out my Patreon page by the link below this video. Without further ado, let's begin! I've gone ahead and created a square canvas with the dimensions of 2000 by 2000 pixels. And we can start drawing the character right away. Today I'm going to use Symmetry tool. It can be found in Actions, under Canvas tab, in the Drawing Guide. If we click Edit Drawing Guide, we can switch to Symmetry, and it is set to vertical by default. We just need to click Done, unless you want to change the color or thickness. In the color palette, I'll select the third color from the first column. It's this light brown. And today I'm going to use my texture and patterns brush set. It has become one of my favorite brush sets lately. I use it quite often. From this set, I will pick textured liner and set the size to 15%. Let's start drawing from the head. And first I will draw an arc approximately from the center of this vertical grid. That will go to the right. And due to symmetry, it will be mirrored on the left side as well. I think streamline of this brush is actually low, so we can increase it to get smooth lines. And next we can draw a big ear to make the character cute. I will make it more round on top, and at the bottom it will be more square. Something like this. From here I'll go down and draw some cute small cheeks. Then go to the left and transition into chin. Let's try to fill the object. I'll drag the color and without lifting the pencil up, slide to the left. Since the brush is textured, it may be not easy to fill it. And once it is filled, I'll fix the gaps. But we got this textured edge. This is what I wanted to achieve. Now it seems to be perfectly fine. Let's now create a layer above this one, clip it, and turn drawing assist on, because I also want to use symmetry here. Let's change the color into the first one and draw the shapes inside the ears. I'll start from here, and at the bottom it may repeat the shape. So I'm just drawing parallel lines, at least trying. Let's also fill these shapes, adjust the color drop threshold, and fix them quickly. Let me make this edge a little more squared. And they can be easily fixed using Liquify. What we are doing on one ear is certainly reflected to the opposite side. Well, I think I like it now. Let me keep it. And on the same layer, I will outline the cheeks with the same color and brush. I'll start from here, draw a line going a little up, and then draw an arc for the nose shape. Let me also fix this arc a little with liquify. Then I will connect it here. Also outline the invisible part of it, so we could fill the shape. I think I will draw the eyes now, to make the character look alive. I'll create another layer and pick this dark color from the third row, from the third column. I'll just lower the brush size to around 5% and draw an oval. Here I will use another method, so I will first draw one eye and then duplicate it. We can edit the shape. I'll drag it closer to the edge, because we know that animals normally don't look straight. Their eyes are located on the sides. Even though it is a cartoon character, I want to make it look more natural. Alright, we have the outline. Now I'll create another layer and change their places. So now the new layer is under the outlines. Next, I will go to outline and set it as reference. Go back to the fourth layer, pick this light color from the third column and drag it inside the oval. You may need to slide a load to the left, because the brush has these gaps. Now we can remove the reference feature here. Alpha lock the fourth layer. Tap here to go to the previous color and draw another oval. Actually, it doesn't have to be perfect here. I'll just outline the shape this way. Can be a little squared. Something like this. I will also fill it and paint the gaps inside with the brush. Let's keep it locked and change the color into this light gray. We need to change the brush into subtle cracks. And here the size is set to 50%. I'll just make one stroke here to add the texture. Then I'll create another layer. It can be above this one. Go back to textured liner and draw a small circle. Even though it is gray, it will work as a reflected light. I'll move it a little inwards and then fill. The first eye is ready. I will group these three layers, duplicate this group. And as I said before, I will simply drag it to the left side, but before that I will flip it horizontal. Also place it close to the edge. I will only open the group and displace the light reflection, dragging it to the right. Now both eyes are ready. Let's create a new layer for the nose. First, I will pick this dark color and draw a shape like this. It also doesn't have to be perfect. And symmetrical. just something cute. Let's fill it. And alpha lock the layer to shade. Here I will also use this light gray. And in the brushes, I'll select grainy pencil. It is in full opacity and size. I'll start drawing on top of it, slightly. Add in the highlight. Then lower the size and press more on the edge. So it's not grainy. The grains will stay only inside. That's it. To make the deer look like deer, we can draw the horns. Also using symmetry. Of course, we need to create a new layer and get it assisted. I will make them dark. And also use textured liner. I'll start drawing from here, go to the side, make the first curve, then the second one that will be bigger. And the last one. Let's make sure we don't have any gaps. This corner. Maybe this one is too round. Okay. Now we can try to fill it. Don't forget to adjust the color drop threshold, because this brush is a little capricious. Okay, I think these shapes look cute. We can alpha lock the layer. But I will remove assisted drawing here to apply shading. Let's also select this light gray and grainy pencil, same as we used on the nose. I'll start shading it on this side, making a few strokes, then the next one. We can lower the size to be more accurate, go a little down, and then the last shape. Let's work on the second horn. And here I will draw highlights on the same side, which is the left one from me. Then I will change the brush to textured liner and add a few lines this way. Just as a decoration. On this one, they don't have to be exactly the same. Okay, now the horns are almost ready. We will decorate them with flowers later. I think it's time to shade the head. And we can start with this brown part. I will remove drawing assist and alpha lock the layer. Here I will be using all colors from the second row. And we can start with this one in the middle. And here I'm going to use dry brush. If you have downloaded this set from previous tutorials, you can go to properties and lower minimum size to 2%, because it is rather big. Let's set the brush size to 32%. And start making various strokes. This brush is unpredictable due to its dry texture. So if you don't like the stroke, you can always undo. I'll keep adding the color. And also make strokes here on the nose. That will go up. I'll draw around the eyes. And then continue. We can try to separate the ears and the head with the strokes here. Once it is done, we can change the color into the dark one, below the previous one. I'll make more strokes here, then on this edge. On the opposite ear. So I turned the assisted drawing off to get various shapes, so they don't repeat. And we get a diverse pattern. Let's lower the brush opacity a little, so the nose doesn't get too dark. I'll start making the strokes from here. Try not to press on the pencil too much. A couple of strokes on this side, then on the opposite one. Here it'll work as a shadow. Finally, I will select this light color and draw more. Mostly on top, making the strokes go down. This area will be covered with flowers, so we don't have to pay much attention to it right now. Couple of strokes on this ear for the highlights. And I think we can switch to textured liner. Make the size around 12% and just add these random lines. Sort of hatch. Let's paint a few on the nose. They can be shorter. And here I will also change the color back to this brown and add a few with this color as well. Sort of dead pattern. Okay, now we can shade these light parts as well. So in the colors I will pick pink, and in the brushes switch to textured shader. I will also start making the strokes here, inside the ears. Since these ears and cheeks are on the same layer, we need to be careful not to draw on the cheeks. Okay, with the same color I will paint here. After that, change the color into this one. lower the size a little. And first make more strokes inside the ears for the shading. In the middle. And then on the sides. Then I will also draw on the cheeks at the bottom. Try to make uniform shading. Also, I will create a new layer above this one and grab this reddish color. Also, change the brush to grainy shader. Its opacity is at about 20%. Let's not forget to clip the layer. And add these freckles on the cheeks. We can merge all these layers and create another one above. Also select this dark brown and textured liner. I will draw some shape for the eyebrows, since it is still a cartoon character. And in my imagination, it is a girl. Then I'll draw the second one. Next, I'm going to create a layer above all layers to draw the flowers. And I will start with this blue in the middle. Let's keep textured liner and draw a simple flower shape. Mine will have just 4 petals. Let me fill it. And then I will shade it quickly. First, I'll create a layer above it and pick this dark color. Let me now remove the grid. I just don't like it. So I'm drawing an oval. And fill in it. Then I'll go back to this layer with blue color and alpha lock it. I will first pick blue and dry brush. I will make it full opacity and rather low size, around 6%. Draw inside the flower. This way we can sort of determine other petals that are inside. I will also increase the brush size and shade the petals on the sides. Right after that, I will switch to a color above, here in the fifth column, and make more strokes inside. This is a very simple cartoon flower. We can pick this light color. And with textured liner, add a few lines inside. First, make the size low, like 5%. Okay, now instead of drawing other flowers, I will simply merge these two layers, duplicate it, go to the flower below and drag it to the left. We don't need magnetics. I will just scale it in uniform mode and place it on the left. We can also rotate it, so they don't look exactly the same. I'll drag it a little up, then pick this red color and drag it on the darkest areas of blue color. Increase color drop threshold. Now it has more shades of red. I'll duplicate the blue flower once again, and this time drag one of them to the right. Also make it smaller and rotate to the opposite side. It can be a little bigger as well. I mean bigger than the red one. And this flower will be colored with this yellowish color. This time I will drag it on the light areas. Fine. We can now duplicate the yellow and red flowers and place them on the horns. And to change them, we can use distort, so they will get sort of angle. I'll place this one here, then duplicate the red flower, drag it up, also rotate, scale it first, and then distort. It can be even smaller. Okay, like this. I'll duplicate the red flower one last time to place it on the opposite horn. Let me first scale it and place it here. I will also distort it a little, so this side will be bigger. Okay. Now that we have flowers, we can add a few leaves. And for the leaves, I will be using these greens, starting from the one in the middle. Let me check if we have textured liner. Okay. I will draw a few leaves of simple shapes. We can merge all the layers for the flowers and create a new layer. Can be located above. Then I will draw leaves of simple shapes. They'll just consist of two arcs. I will fill them, adjusting the color drop threshold. Maybe a couple of leaves here, making one of them smaller and the other one bigger. Also fill in. Let's draw same leaves on the opposite horn. Or actually, we can duplicate these after we shade them. We can only add the leaves under the flowers that will go down on the head. I'll start from here, and here I will make the shapes of the leaves slightly curved. Fill in them. Then I will draw two more in this gap, also making it slightly curvy. and maybe one leaf going this way. Let's shade them quickly. For that we need to alpha lock the layer if we don't want to create a clipping mask. And then I'll switch to the color below. Also select dry brush. We can set the size to 25% and just make random strokes on the leaves. After that, I will select this light green and add more strokes. You can try to make the size smaller to be sure that it doesn't cover the entire leaf. And as I said, I will outline these leaves. Click copy and paste here. Then flip it and drag to the opposite side. Just to save some time. Okay. Now these decorations are done. We can now merge these layers, even all layers for the head, and create a layer below to draw the neck. Here I will be using the same brown color together with textured liner, and I'm not sure if I want to use symmetry. Maybe it will be better if we draw it by hand. So I will first draw the neck and then make this curve. And then on the opposite side. Sometimes these imperfections work better than making it all perfect. Let's connect the edges and then fill it. After that, I will select this light color that we used on the ears and cheeks, create a layer above this one, and clip it. Here I will outline the following way. On both sides. We also need to connect it at the bottom and on top, and then fill. Before we shade it, I want to draw the scarf. It will be located on the layer above this one, and I want to make it blue, but you can use either red or yellow. They will work as well. So I'm picking this bluish color in the middle and drawing the shape on the side, slightly curvy. Then I will draw sort of an arc here. Connect it and drag the color inside. Then I'll create one more layer, and I think I will lower the opacity of the previous one. Since they have the same color, we won't be able to see. And now it will work better. I'll draw the shape on the side. It will be slightly wavy. Can be straight at the bottom, and then we'll go up. Let's make sure we don't have any gaps, and then drag the color inside the shape as well. Let me use liquify to fix it a little. Okay. This will be better. After that, I will create a layer between these two. And draw another shape that will go slightly to the right. I will make it curvy at the bottom. Then just connect the edges and also fill it. Okay, we can bring back the opacity of the fourth layer. And now shade all these three layers quickly. I will start with this horizontal one. So I'm just locking it. And I will start with the dark color, which is this blue. Here I will be using dry brush. Its size is at around 20%. I'll make the strokes under the head first to add the shadow. It will also go on the left. Maybe the size can be bigger. Then I will pick a lighter color, like this one, and make the strokes inside. Let's also shade these two shapes by alpha locking them, first applying darker color. I'm starting with the shadows and then I will highlight it with this one on the edge. Going to the fifth layer, also locking it, adding shadow under the head first and then adding the strokes at the bottom. You can try to lower the opacity so we get more shades of the same color. And then I will pick the color from top. Make more strokes. To make it cute, I want to add a pattern with this very light color. You can pick any of these or use any of the patterns that you have, but I will pick lines pattern. Its size is at 42%. I'll just make one stroke on each layer. Now it's ready. We can shade the body. And I'm going to start with a layer of brown color. We need to alpha lock it. And I'm going to use the colors that we used on the head. Starting with this brown. And actually, dry brush will work here as well. I'm just changing the size to 52% and making these strokes. Then I will go with this dark color. Continue. And finally, I will pick this light brown or beige. The size can be smaller. Just making a few strokes for the pattern. All right. We also need to add the cast shadow from the scarf. I will use this dark color and textured shader. Just painting under it. Once we did that, we can shade this light layer. I'm also alpha locking it and picking this pinkish color. On this layer, I will use textured shader as well. Just increasing the size to around 35% and making the strokes going down. After that, I will select this brownish color and make even more strokes. Let's also add a shadow. I will pick this dark color from the third column, but lower the brush opacity, since the main color is light. I will also lower the brush size and draw this way. We can add the shadow here as well. Okay, I think the deer is totally ready now. We can add the background. First, I'm going to merge all the layers, create a new layer and drag it under. For the background, I will be using color number 6. So I'm just dragging it on the canvas. After that, I'll create a layer above it and select the color below. Let me select grainy pencil and draw a circle around the deer. We can tap to make it perfect and center it. I will keep the same borders from all sides. Now let's try to drag the color inside it. And we may need to adjust the color drop threshold, because this brush is also textured. I will increase its size and go more around the edge. To make it more grainy. Well, I think it is okay. We can create a layer above the circle and clip it. I want to add textures on it first. So I'm changing the color into a darker one below and also harsh cracks. Since this color is darker, I will draw mostly at the lower part of the circle. We can lift the pencil up and draw again. After that, I will pick a darker color on the right and draw even more. At the bottom. Then we can pick the color right from the background and draw on top. Let's keep the same color and pick some pattern. I will pick the one with the seeds. And they look a little like water droplets. So maybe we will draw the rain. I'm drawing all over the circle. And I think I'll make it slightly bigger. Then I will switch to this light color and also pick star pattern. Draw more inside the circle. Personally, to me, the more textures the better. Now that we have the background on the circle, we can draw the trees. I'm merging these two layers and creating another one. As the base color for the trees, I will be using color number 24. and textured liner. Let's first draw a tree in the middle. So I will just draw two vertical lines that go throughout the canvas. And then fill it. I think we need to fix this line and try to fill again. Now it worked. I will also add a few small branches on the sides. And on the opposite side. Can be slightly bigger. Let's also fill it. And then I will add a smaller branch. We can draw another tree on the side. And then just copy it. I don't want to make my tutorials too long. That's why I'm trying to find ways to shorten it. By duplicating the objects, using symmetry, and other tools. Here I will draw a small branch going to the right. Now that we have the tree shapes, we can clip them to the circle and alpha lock. I will shade them using textured shader and I will go with black color. Just lower the brush opacity so it doesn't get pure black. I will also increase the brush size to 34% and start making vertical strokes, not pressing too much on the pencil. Here I will press a little more. Also at the bottom of the small branch. And then shade this tree in the middle. Draw on the sides. Here. On the small branch. Go up. And with a smaller size, draw on the opposite side. After we added this subtle shading, we can work with the highlights. And for the highlights, I will use white color that I will also pick from the disk. With the same low opacity, I will start making the strokes inside, also up and down. And due to low opacity, we don't get pure white color. It is more light gray. I'll just lower the size and draw more on the edge to highlight it, then the opposite one and on this tree. Let's keep white color for now and change the brush to textured liner. I will add some vertical lines inside the trees. But we also need to lower the brush opacity to around 40% and brush size. I'll set it to 3%. And draw the vertical lines, not making them perfect. Maybe the size can be like 4%. We can add them on the branches as well. And as I said before, I will simply duplicate the tree on the left. For that, I will first outline it. Then copy and paste. I will also flip it horizontal, drag it to the side, and clip it. Then I will adjust its location. Move it a little up or down. And also more to the side. Approximately like this. We can also clip our deer to the circle. We can totally merge these two layers and then clip the deer. After that, I will create a layer between the deer and the trees. Select this dark color and go to the brush set with flowers. Here we have a few simple stamps. I made this brush set specially for another tutorial, but why not use it here? I will just use these leaves. Tap on the canvas and place them behind the deer. I'll create another layer and change the stamp. I'll rotate this one and drag it to the left. I will also use one more. Finally, I will add a few fallen leaves, and for that I'll create a new layer right above all layers. I will use these two colors, so we can start with the light one. Go back to the texture set and pick textured liner. I will draw simple shapes, but the brush needs to be in full opacity. They may cross the circle. It's totally fine. And I will draw them in different directions. A couple on the right, and maybe two more on the opposite side. I don't want it to be symmetrical, so I'll draw another leaf here under the ear. Also fill it, and then alpha lock this layer. Let's pick the color below for shading, together with dry brush. I'll just make a few strokes on each leaf. Also, I will select this dark color, go back to textured liner, and with a small brush size, draw these patterns inside the leaves. Still keeping it very simple. Here. And these two. Since we have this color in brush, I think we can unlock the layer and add the lines inside these leaves as well. and here. To me it looks better. And the final touch is I want to add a shadow on the trees from the deer. So I will go to the layer with the trees. They are already locked and we have the required color. I will just change the brush to textured shader and draw this way under the ears. Also on this tree. Then I will go to the layer with the circle. Also alpha lock it. And add the shadows around the trees first. This way we can add some depth to our drawing. And separate the trees from the background, since they have very similar colors. I will also add a shadow on the background from the deer. Maybe on one side. And also around the leaves. But for that we need to create another layer under the leaves, since the circle is locked. I'll just draw this way on the side of the leaf, then here, and also here. Finally, our drawing can be considered done. Make sure to tag me in your Instagram post and I'll do my best to check it out. If you enjoy drawing this character, you can find more videos like this one here on my channel. And for more tutorials and different styles, you can visit my Patreon page. Thank you for watching and see you soon!